lesson plan, the record of our cover, the progress record, the class attendance register, the teaching and learning materials, all of them. So you must have those documents. If you use those documents, I'm telling you, these children will never get a B, they will never get a C minor, they will never get a D. So please, I know all of you are trained, whether it's primary or secondary, and therefore, please plan and prepare. The other thing is about identifying the gaps. The gaps in teaching and learning among your learners. If, for example, 5 children are brought today, don't just admit them in class. So it's important at least you assess them. So when you're assessing them, you are not chasing them away. You're only convincing the parent that I want to know where your child can be well placed. A parent can come and tell you my child is in form 3 and you want him to be admitted in form 3. Don't just accept. Don't accept even some transfers from nowhere, because some transfers you have to be very careful. Transfer in the past was a letter written by the head teacher of the transferring school, the one who sent the child to another school. These days it's not there. It's a form which comes to my office, it has to be endorsed, it has to go to all places, including the sending head teacher or principal or the receiving head teacher or principal. Those forms are available, they are in our office. Please come for them.